this is the Mason house. What do you think?
Oh, I love everything.
Looks like a great house. Nice front yard.
Nice place for the kids to play. I'm looking at the roof. Seems pretty good.
Yeah, the roof looks new. Mm-hmm.
The Mason house, 4 bedrooms, 3 baths, 2,900 square feet, was built in 1966, and they're asking $170,000 for it.
Okay.
We call it the Mason house because Betty and Dick Mason lived here for 43 years. She was a lifelong nurse, mm-hmm. and he was a landman in the oil industry.
Okay.
This is what I love about a house where one family lived here for a really long time. They took great care of it. It's in ship shape. It's all a matter of style and what you guys like.
Okay.
I don't want to spend a ton of your budget on the outside of the house.
Oh, okay.
I like that. Subtle.
It is very subtle. We take these iron bars off the windows and give you a new front door that has windows in it. That's something a little bit more modern, lets in more natural light. And then build this sort of a partition wall with wood slats that is kind of a decorative element you would see in mid-century houses that would, in this case, kind of push this house into the 2020s modern version. And that's kind of it on the outside.
And on the exterior, we would only spend about $5,000.
You want to save your budget for the inside. So let's go inside next.
Okay. Can't wait.
So tile comes down, islands out of here. We're keeping the lowers over there and the lowers over here.
Not
this,
layout.
All
gone.
I'm going up.
Okay. Whoa! Front of the oven just shattered like glitter.
Hey, Erin.
Yeah.
Looks like we have brick.
Heyo!
It's in good shape. It's gonna need a sealer though.
That's okay. Hey, look at this.
What's it say?
It's just like the original paperwork. It says that these cabinets were cherry.
Very fancy.
Keep going. I want to get this thing out.
All right, Katie. I'm demoing the rug. Well, you are too. You think these plugins still work?
I would hope so. They're really not that old. This was a carport, so they would have added them later.
Think this was a carport?
Yeah, because that's an outdoor grill.
That's what I was thinking. Do we think that's what it was?
Yes. And the plumbers told me that that's a hood vent.
Okay.
It goes out. And then those doors were access to propane. Yeah. Have some good football parties in here.
All right, let's start at the plugins. Cutting this. All right, here we go.
Nothing fun under here.
Concrete.
So clean, it's just not even dusty at all.
It's nice, smooth, level. There's a little bit of linoleum. I don't know what that part would have been, but we're going back with engineered hardwood, so, I mean, we're not gonna have any problems.
Well, we're finally bringing cabinets into the biggest kitchen on planet Earth.
Son, we're going with 3 hours.
Let's bring one more up in here.
Let's rip this one off the wall and put it over there. Then you got mom, dad, little boy, little girl.
Everybody's own island.
Private space.
Well, this is one. This is gonna come together.
But still, that's gonna be a lot of island space.
And we'll just paint it all after.
The cabinets aren't painted yet because we have to paint all of the cabinets.
The original ones too, that we reused. So it's gonna look a little patchy. For now, but not for long.
I think it's gonna really shape up to be a really nice kitchen.
Yeah, they wanted something modern and clean.
Sure.
Not cluttered.
I don't think they're gonna have to worry about clutter. They'll have plenty of places to store stuff.
Yeah. There's some storage here. That's gonna be the best vacation home ever. Brick floors are amazing.
Brick floors are beautiful.
People love them. This is the main thing. That is not sealed.
There are some parts of the kitchen floor that were covered up by cabinets. We need to reseal them, make it all even.
And they're gonna use that chemical process.
They're gonna hot strip.
Hot stripping.
That's my favorite activity.
Hot stripping.
Cold stripping's not usually as desirable. Brock and Ashley are about to come home. We took a very 60s house and turned it into something modern and fresh for a young family. The thing about this house is only a few key points were a priority for the Robinsons. They wanted to focus on the big common areas where the family will be together. It feels like home in here. It doesn't even feel like a vacation home. It feels like a home home. And that's the goal.
Well, before we showed you the Bush House, but this is the Robinson House.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I love it. Look at it.
Ironwork is gone.
It is gone.
Thank you for noticing.
Oh, wow.
Oh, look at that.
Removing the scrolly, swirly ironwork that was definitely not you, and giving it a more modern take on this mid-century style.
I love that.
Y'all, it's beautiful.
It looks totally different.
Our hope was to use a little of this dark accent color just to break up the wash of brick and tan.
Yes.
To have some contrast.
I love it.
The outside were the small changes. We wanted to save your money for the big changes on the inside in the backyard. So you ready?
Yes.
You want to see?
Yes.
Brooke, look! Oh my God! It's beautiful!
Right?
Oh my God, you guys rock. Oh my goodness, this is totally different.
Do you feel like you're on vacation?
Do I?
Yes.
I do.
Yes.
Yeah?
This is a dream kitchen.
It's so great! I'm so happy for y'all.
I don't even have the words for it, Erin. It's beautiful. My
islands.
Everybody can gather, like my whole family.
The brickwork is still here?
Yes, I still love my brick floors.
Original floors.
The backsplash.
The backsplash is gorgeous.
It reminds me of watercolor.
It does.
And also ice cubes.
Oh, yes. The ceiling, holy moly.
This is a little better.
Y'all, this is amazing. This is beyond like my expectations. Like, I won't leave the kitchen ever.
What are you gonna cook in here? What's the first thing?
Oh, I gotta fix my seafood stew.
I've been thinking about the seafood stew.
Don't worry, I'm inviting you over. I'm just loving everything.
You
see? Yep, it's here for you.
Oh, that's so sweet.
That's nice.
Yep. Hey, I'm in love. I love you, but I definitely love this kitchen.
Can we move to the den?
Okay, I'll be back, kitchen.
Yeah, you can come back.
I'll be back.
Oh, no more carpet.
No
more carpet.
The carpet is gone. And the blue from the kitchen. Hey!
Fireplace.
That thing is gone, whatever that was.
Yeah,
hibachi grill.
We figured out what it was.
What was it?
This used to be a carport.
It was outside.
And they used this as like an outdoor patio.
Okay.
And that was a grill.
Now it makes sense.
This is beautiful. Yeah. I love it. It's nice and airy in here as well.
We brightened it up and lightened it up so much, especially that wall. We thought it would be fun to, as a nod to the 60s and 70s when the house was in its heyday, to give you a wood paneled wall with vertical V groove, but to paint it out the crisp white that you want.
That's cool.
And your kitchen cabinets were cherry. We took some of that cherry, and this is a cherry and walnut checkers and chess table.
Aww.
Yeah. Okay. Mallory and I made the pieces for you, and so you just flip them over if you want to play checkers. Yeah.
We'll love it. We'll play.
Yeah, you two could play each other.
You ready to get beat?
Not worried about that.
We're very competitive.
Yeah. Haven't noticed at all.
She doesn't stand a chance.
Talking about your kitchens, about whose kitchen will be better.
Mine.
We haven't even seen Brock's kitchen.
Yeah.
I have a feeling
mine is great.
No.
Go see.
His has a pool.
Go see before we make a decision.
I have a pool.
Well, I'll let you see it first.
Can't wait to see it. Oh, wow.
Holy moly.
My kitchen's better.
Oh, God.
Seafood.
Yes. Oh my goodness. Okay, bud.
I don't even know what to look at first.
It's gonna be so much fun in the summer, but it's also ready for winter. Put firewood in the fireplace and have a fire out here.
Oh wow.
It'd be so great.
I don't even know what to say.
You got a burner.
You know what that's for?
Yes. A pot will fit right on here.
Uh-huh.
And then you eat it over here.
You dump it on this crawfish table, all right? So
yes.
So this was something we built in the wood shop. You got stainless and cypress, and this will all hold up really well outside.
I love it.
The best part is that the top comes off, and so it'll all break down. You can put it in storage when you're not using it.
But you know, I think I would just keep it out to use for like a cooking work surface.
I would.
But when you're cooking and grilling.
I'm pretty sure I'll do a lot of seafood.